So guys, first topic today would be for command line. Like, what is command line in F5? Everyone talks, everyone says that some commands which can be like, there are two things in F5. One is GUI and one is CLI. So command line basically based on your Linux. So everything on F5 is based on your Linux. So you should know some few Linux commands which will help you to troubleshoot different issues in your production environment. So we will talk about what are the architecture of command line and how you can troubleshoot. So let's go further on that part and we will talk on that. So basically, let's say I have to create a virtual server through command line. Everyone knows that we can create a virtual server through GUI. So this template is GUI. So you go to local traffic, virtual servers, and you create it. But let's say if someone wants to create your virtual server using CLI. So what is the architecture on that? What is this create command? What is this LTM? What is this virtual? So let's talk about this architecture, like how to create virtual server using command line and what are the commands you can see which are important and which are helpful in troubleshooting. I will tell you everything. Let's talk about architecture. So if I talk about architecture of command line, it will follow the hierarchical architecture. First, your modules can be your LTM, your GTM box, your ASM box, or your APM box. So this will cover your hierarchical architecture. What is the module? What is the component? Component can be your virtual server, can be your pool, can be your profile. So your TMSH or traffic management shell. So this TMSH, people ask, what is this TMSH? So TMSH is a traffic management shell, which will give you the Linux shell. So this will be helpful in creating your commands. So what are the different commands? So how it will help you? So it is divided in hierarchical architecture. So let's say we have a module here. We have decided components and what is the command. So module, and this, let's talk about further on that part, but you need to understand your command line works like that. So let's talk about what are the modules and what how hierarchical architecture works. So I will go and I will show you. So see, so first of all, when you log in into CLI, you will get this mod. So that is called root level TMSH mode. Whenever you log in into your F5, it will come like this. Config mode. Can you see this config mode? It will come like this. Then to go to TMOS, which is your traffic management operating system, you need to type TMSH. So that is how to navigate, because it's a Linux based shell. To jump from one directory to another, you need to run few commands. So TMSH, by default, it will go to root level, which will be like this. Then if you need to run TMOS, like I need to run some stats, I need to see virtual server stats. So what I will run list or show command. So list will give me configuration and show will give me stats. So I will show you that. So this is the navigation which you need to follow in hierarchical structure. Then let's talk about further on how Linux commands are and what are the Linux command which generally help. So now if I talk about hierarchical structure which I was talking about, it consists of modules. So let's say you have a TMOS module which is your operating system of F5. Then see, we have modules. Modules can be GTM, LTM, or network, or CLI, or authentication module. Then submodules, and then components. So this is how your hierarchical architecture. If you need to go to from TMOS to modules, then you need to run this. You need to score slash GTM, then it will go to TMOS.GTM if you want to run monitor. So it's like navigation. Navigation from one directory to another directory. So that is how it goes. First, it goes to TMOS. Then you want to go to GTM module. Then it will go like this. Then you want to go to LTM for a particular submodule. Let's say I want to see what are the monitor settings configured on my LTM box. Then you need to go to monitor tab. And this is how it goes like. Then it's a component. Let's say you need to see something on HTTP profile. Let's say you need to take some VLAN information. So you need to understand in which module, which configuration is present. So let me show you one example which will help you in understanding. Let's jump into our CLI command and I will show you. What I will do is I will go to PuTTY and I will log in. I will just change my settings to bold. So see, I will log in into root. So can you see this, guys? What is this? I have showed you that by default, F5 will log in into TMSH. This is your root level. Now I need to jump navigate to my traffic management operating system. So in that, what I need to run the command is TMOS. So this is how your hierarchical architecture is. So what I will do is I will run the command TMSH. So see, now the component from TMSH, this slash, can you say this hash changed to TMOS hash. So this is how I change from Linux shell to my operating system shell. So this is the command TMSH. This is very, very important in your production also. You need to run how to jump from one directory to another. So you need to run command TMSH. It will jump to your TMOS mode, which is your traffic management mode. So now let's say how to navigate to the architecture. So what I will do is, let's say I was showing you LTM module. So can you see this? When I type LTM, it has jumped to TMOS.LTM. So you don't need to remember anything. If you're using LTM module, just type LTM module and go into direct stats like this. So what I did was I just typed LTM in TMOS and it came into LTM module. So it's hierarchical structure. Modules, submodules, and components. So it's so easy. You don't need to remember. And people say, do I need to remember any command? No. Everything, you just need to understand architecture of CLI. That's it, which I showed you. So see, so first it's module, then it's submodules, then it's a components. That's it. You need to just remember this. Modules, submodule, and how to jump into components. Let me jump into the practical. So what I did was I did LTM. Now if I need to run some command, you can just type help. So help will give you all commands. Suppose you need to create any virtual server, so you will use this keyword create. Suppose I want to modify IP address, so you need to run modify. Suppose I need to reboot my box from CLI, you just need to type reboot. So can you see this? It's giving me different modules, components, commands. So this is as easy as that. So what we did was we just jumped into LTM. Then what would be the my next step? Suppose my requirement is I want to see all pool in my LTM box. I want to see all pool configuration using CLI. This is my requirement. Let's say I do not able to access my GUI. I want to see all components using CLI. So what is the command? Let's go in hierarchical architecture. What I will do is, I will go to my pool now. So can you see this? First it was TMOS, then it was module, then it's a subcomponent. So we have entered into TMOS.LTM.pool. So we are jumping hierarchically. I'm again saying you need to remember this. Module, submodule, and components. Again repeating, it's very, very easy. So what I will do is, I will now, let's say I need to see all the configuration. So what I will do is, I will run command show. So can you see this? So what is, people have a question, what is difference between show and list? So this is very, very important. Perspective of your certification and perspective of your production. So what is the difference between show command versus list? Show command will give you statistics related to either virtual server or either pool or any other stats like profile, persistence, any stats. But list, what is list? List will give you the configuration. Configuration part of your component. So I will show you this, what is difference between, but you need to remember this. List command will give you configuration related to pool. If you want to run particular pool, you need to see particular pool. You need to see particular virtual server. So you need to run this command. But show will give you the stats, real-time stats. That is what is the difference between show and list command. So what I did was, my first task, let's go step by step. My first task, let me say that my customer or my requirement is, my task for today is to see all virtual server. So what command I need to run? So what would be the answer? So that is important. So in this case, your answer would be, you just need to run list command. But can you see this? I have right now TMOS.LTM.pool. When I run list command, it will show me pool configuration. But I need to see virtual server configuration. So what I need to do is, I will go to help and see where is my, how to see virtual server. So I will go to help. In help, what I will do is, first I need to run LTM. TMOS.LTM. Let's go exit. Okay. Exit, sometimes it's my 12 version. So I need to, when I go to back to the directory, so I need to run exit command. So it will be coming into tmos.ltm. Now I need to go to virtual server. So I will run help command. So go here and see this. Can you see this? There are two commands, virtual and virtual address in the component. So I need to see all virtual. So I will go to virtual. Let me delete this and let me clear. Let me exit. So I will go to what is here. Now I am into TMSH. Then I will go to what where? LTM. Now what is I need to go? You just type V here. It will give you everything. V, then tab. So I will run virtual. So can you see this? Now it has jumped into tmos.ltm.virtual. So that is how it comes. That is why it's called hierarchical architecture. This is so easy. People have queries like, hey, I don't know the commands, how I can run. So I'm telling you step by step how to check it according to your requirement. Now I want to see all virtual servers. So what I will do is just type list. So list will give you all virtual server. Can you see this? It's giving me the same configuration which is present in my GUI. So I've just typed list. It's giving me all configuration. So currently I have two virtual server. One is this and one is this. So can you this see this? It's giving me all my virtual server configuration. That is how you did. So it's so easy. Now what I will do is I will jump here again. I will clear the screen. What I will do is I will run LTM. Now I will again press V, virtual. Now I want to see the stats, whether I'm getting traffic. So my now requirement is I want to see the traffic flow, whether I'm getting packets on my virtual server or not. So my another use case is I want to see traffic flow. I want to see whether traffic is coming on my virtual server or not. So how to see this? So I will go step by step. This is very, very important. If you know 3-4 commands, you can run more commands also. But you need to understand this architecture. This is very, very important. So you can type also here help. Like what are the other options available in virtual server? See, it will give you command. That's what I want to share. So it's giving me command, create the virtual. Then it will give you more command. So it's giving me name, configure a virtual server, module LTM, and it's giving me syntax. That's what I wanted to show you. You just need to type help and you need to run, just understand the architecture. That's it. So it's giving me the name, which I need to give, what is the module, and what is the syntax. You just type help command, that's it. So what I will do is, I will come and I will just press Q. It will come into quit mode. So that is how it is. Now, my use case was, I wanted to see all my virtual server stats. So what I will run is show. So can you see this? Now it's giving me all the stats, what is availability, it's available. What is my IP address of my virtual server? What is the stats? I'm getting all the stats. Bits in, packets out, and what is my current connections and total connection. So it's giving me all the traffic flow. So what is the command? It's a show command. It's also giving me the CPU usage. Like what is the CPU usage per virtual server? You cannot see this using GUI. Also, it will give you the reason. Reason can be seen by GUI, but you need to understand what is CLI. If you know CLI, you can crack any interview. That's my surety. even your scripting language. Suppose you are a good engineer, you should know little bit on Python or Ansible. If you know this architecture, you will able to run any scripting. But you need to run how architecture works. You need to understand this. So it's showing me all the virtual server with the stats. So this is my second virtual server, which is on port 80. And this is my virtual server on port 443. So that is how you can see this. So now what I can do is, now my requirement is, I will just press Q and I will go to this. Now guys, my another use case is, I want to see all profiles. Profiles can be your TCP or your HTTP profiles, or you can say persistence or anything. How to see that? Through virtual server. So you need to understand where it comes. So first, let me do exit here and let's do help. So let's go exit, then I will run help. So where can someone tell me where it's, where is the profile section? Can you see this? Profile section is coming in this. So that is how you need to see what is the profile in the component. So how you can jump in, you just need to type help command and you will see different components. So just type help and it is giving me commands, components and modules, which is very, very important. So what I will do is I will delete this and I will come into end. And I will just press exit or Q option. So to see this, what I'm doing is I will go to profile. So see, I need to see tmos.ltm.profile. I want to see all my profiles. So what command I run? So I need to run list command. So see, it's giving me all the profiles so far created. But let's see what is, I want to see all the profiles more. So I will run help and you can see. If I want to see any all TCP profile, so I will enter control L, then I will go to TCP. Can you see this? tmos.ltm.profile.tcp. It will show me all the TCP components profile. So I will run list. Can you see this? It will show me all the profiles related to TCP. Now I need to run exit and I need to see all the profiles related to HTTP. My another use case is I want to see all HTTP related profiles. All HTTP profiles so far created. So you need to run HTTP and then list. So see, it's showing me all the profiles related to HTTP available in my F5 box. So that is how you need to navigate. Now, my another use case. I want to see all health monitors components. What are the health monitors available on my F5 box? So guys, what would be the your answer? So I will press exit. I will press exit. I will go to help. And I will see what is the monitor configuration available, whether it's available in component or modules. So see, monitor is available in your components. There it is. So I will go and show you. So this is the monitor. So what I will do is, I will delete this. And I will press exit. So what I will do is I will mention monitor. I will just tap M, then tab. It will give you whatever is starting from M keyword. So it will give me. So I will just press enter. What is the command to see all monitor? I will just press list. So it will give me all monitors, whether HTTP, TCP, ICMP. What is available right now in the box. So you can just see HTTP, HTTP, ICMP. So what I did was I get into TMOS, then I entered LTM, then I entered monitor. And it showed me all monitor configuration. So that is how it works. You can see n number of configuration. You tell me what you need to see. You will get it from F5. That's it. That's how it works. So let me summarize what we have done is. So first, you need to understand what is show command, what is list command, what is help command. So I run this all commands so far. Then how to navigate. So I'm just repeating again, save command. You need to understand this component, show, list, help. So show command will help you to view stats, status, and your runtime information. And your list command will help you to provide your actual configuration on the box. So if you want to see anything, whether related to virtual server profiles, pools, monitor, list command. Your help is very useful when you are not familiar with CLI. This is very, very important. So it will give you all the features like syntax and let's say if you talk about you don't know anything related to pool, so you can run type help, then you can type LTM, then you can type pool. So it will give you CLI syntax with description and example. Let's see how help commands will help you. I have shown you, but I'm just showing you again. I will delete this. So what I will do is, let's go to exit. I'm just coming into TMOS. Okay, so I will just press help. Then my LTM, than my pool. So can you say this? It will give me name, module, and how to create pools or modify pool settings. So I just type help, then LTM pool. So it's giving me CLI syntax, description, and configuration example. How to create a pool. This is all the steps written. You do not need to anything, worry it. So how to create a pool? You just need to come type this. Create pool, then type help. Let me show you how we can create a new pool through CLI. What I will do is, I will press Q, Control L. Now I will just create, my use case is, I will be creating new pool with two members through CLI. So I just got, I did help LTM pool. I run this command help LTM pool and it helped me to understand this. Like create is a command to create a pool. So I will run this and then I will type help. So I will delete this. So I will run create, then tab, LTM, then pool. Then see, new pool, you need to give the name of the pool name. Let's say pool of two. Then see what I will run. I have given the name. Now I will type tab. So I am getting members, like how to create pool members. So first I need to give load balancing mode. What would be my load balancing mode? Load balancing mode. Then I type, see, step by step it will give you. I will type round robin. So see, what I did was, so I just run this command, then I tap tab, then you can type members, then you can add members. Just type tab, then I will add 10.2.2.30 colon 443. That's it. I'm just closing it. So see, so this is the command. You need to understand what is the load balancing algo. I am doing in front of you. I don't have any knowledge. I just type tab, tab, tab. So I want to add this pool member in new pool. So I've created pool name. Then I have set round robin load balancing algo. You just need to understand your concept, what things needed in your pool. Then I typed pool member. Now what is next step generally comes in? It's called health monitor. So let's talk about monitor. Like what is the monitor I need to assign? Let's assign TCP or ICMP. So what I will do, I will delete this and I will just type monitor and I will just say TCP. Now that's it. And I will do Control L and I will enter it. So it's saying that requested pool is already exist because I have created it. So now if I need to modify, I need to assign monitor. So what I need to do, I need to modify LTM pool, then pool name. So it's giving me pool name. So what it will give. So see, now I need to assign monitor TCP. So it has given me monitor TCP. I need to assign members, add, so you can assign it. So it's giving me incomplete command. So it's give me the error also. Why? Because I have entered the wrong. So see, now I will exit, and I will go to CL GUI to see whether pool has created. So I will go and I will type my GUI IP. This one, and I will see whether pool is created or not. So I will log in. And let's see whether pool member has been created or not. I will go to local traffic and pools to see pool member. So see, pool 2 you can see in red because 443 is not listening on port. So see, can you see this health monitor TCP is already assigned? Let's see member. Can you see this? I did not do anything through GUI. Everything I did was from CLI. So this is how you can create. Just typing help and tab command. That's it. I just go hierarchically. That's it. So what I will do is, I will just